Hey guys, today we are cleaning a PS1 controller. The only reason being I got this with the PS1 a couple of months ago and I haven't cleaned it yet. And I highly recommend cleaning every controller you get because we all know how some people treat their controller. And I don't really want to use this before cleaning it properly. This is one of the very early models without the analog sticks and quite honestly, I prefer this over the DualShock controller. So I want to play with the thing and I'll clean it for you and with you. So I thought I'd bring you along for the ride. What do we need? We need a Phillips head screwdriver, a very small one and a very thin one. Then we need something like this, a bowl of water with a bit of soap in it. We need or toothbrush and towel or paper towel to dry everything properly. Okay, I'll take you down to the table and let's take this baby apart. All right guys, welcome to the table. Let's start. I actually had to get another screwdriver because the other one was still too big. So you need a really, really teeny tiny screwdriver with a Phillips head. Well, head. Okay, let's get this open. Nothing too special here, just push that thing in there, screw a little bit and the screws will come out, hopefully. Just a little more. And these things are teeny tiny screws, so you can barely see them on the picture, I think. I'll now do this to all the screws on this controller and I'll see you again once this controller is completely screw free. Okay, now this controller is completely freed of all the screws and I checked the product number is SCPH1080, but I'm sure it works with every other PlayStation 1 controller as well. So just take out all the screws and try not to break it while taking it apart, okay? The back comes off first. Let's see, can we get these triggers out? Looks like they're clipped in, but there's not really a reason to take them out, just clean them alongside the backside and everything will be fine. By the way, the screws are all over here. Don't lose them, don't swallow them, just take care that these will be back in place once the controller is done. Okay, backside over here, nothing special about that. Okay, let's see. Now here, up here are the buttons for the shoulder triggers. This looks a lot more complicated than, let's say, a Super Nintendo controller. Okay, let's take this out carefully in order to not rip any of the cables that are in here. These things come out from the top. They are isolated pieces on their own and everything is just like this. So nothing too special. Let's take this rubber thing off as well so we can clean all of this properly. And put this aside for the second and let's get out all of the buttons. We have these little rubbery buttons for start and select. We have usually this thing is on top of here, but it was stuck to the board. Okay, we have these little buttons, one of these crosses and one of these like underneath crosses, whatever they're called. And of course, four buttons. And they can't be interchanged. They all have these little plastic things, so they only fit into the slot they originally came from. And interesting, on the inside it's still blue. So it's not just the cross, on the inside it's all blue. Interesting. Okay, now the entire thing is taken apart and these are the parts we can actually clean. We can kind of clean the board later on, but these are the things we can clean with this bowl of soap water. Okay, let's start. Really, there's nothing special to this. Just take your thingy, put it into the water and clean it. There's nothing I have to explain to you here. So I'll just take this toothbrush and kind of rub it against all of the holes and all of the corners where the gunk and dirt usually collects. And this way it should be clean in no time. Just take your toothbrush, rub it against everything like you do every morning. but with a PlayStation controller. I must say, the outside of this is already really clean. I don't know if the person I got it from already had it cleaned, but I'll just make 100% sure. But this is already a pretty clean controller. Okay, now this is pretty much clean. I don't see anything that resembles dirt anymore on this thing. And now what we will do is we put it onto a paper towel. Of course, you can use any kind of towel and just let it dry. I would recommend letting it air dry so it's completely 100% dry, especially if you're cleaning consoles. But with controllers, really, you can just clean it. And as long as there's no obvious water in there, it should be fine. But I recommend letting it air dry over there, making 100% sure there's no more water in there, because once it's in there, it's hard to get out. Okay, and same thing with the button, just put it in there, take your toothbrush and kind of rub it against it. I shouldn't have to explain to you how to clean things, but hey, you watched the video, so you're obviously interested. Maybe just in the taking it apart part. So yeah, just take your toothbrush, rub it against all of the corners and things to get all the dirt out that's collected there, especially on the inside where you usually can't get to. I mean, on the outside you can still just wipe it off, but here you have the chance to clean it properly. Alright, I guess I'll just see you again once I have everything cleaned, because watching this is pretty boring, isn't it? Okay, see you in a couple of seconds. Okay, now let's take the chance to clean this thing a little bit. There's really not much you can do unless you want to like really take it apart and do things. I recommend getting a little Q-tip and some kind of window cleaner. But if you don't have that, just take a little bit of soap water. Not too much, just a little bit, so the tip is a bit moist. And then rub it against the contacts. If your controller is unresponsive, then clean it with the other side. Or dry it, I should say. If your controller is a bit unresponsive, it could be that there's a bit of corrosion on there. And doing this may help you to restore your controller. So there's a little bit of water on the table, if you're asking. So yeah, I repaired, in quotation marks, a couple of Master System and Mega Drive controllers that way. So if your controllers are a bit unresponsive, if you think your button pushes don't come all the way through, I recommend cleaning the contacts a little bit. And be careful that there's not too much water or moisture on the entire thing. So be sure that you dry every contact off once you've cleaned it a little bit. So yeah, that's pretty much it. That's all I can do, at least, because I'm not that good at taking things apart and soldering and all of that stuff. Okay, now these are drying here, and once they are kind of done, we'll see each other again. So see you in a couple of minutes. Yeah. Okay, so everything is pretty much dry. What I did is I took another paper towel and I took the buttons and I rubbed along the side, because there was still a little bit of dirt on there, and just by rubbing it off with a paper towel, you should get that off pretty easily. So now our next step is trying to put all of this back together. Okay, we start, of course, with this part. We take, first of all, this cross-shaped D-pad, and then there's this thing, the like rocker or something. It fits perfectly into these corners, so you shouldn't have any problem putting this thing back in. Okay, now let's do the buttons first. Okay, I'll try to do this. I think this one should be over here, right? The circle should be... No, the circle is not over here. Okay, I'm not too familiar with the PlayStation controller, to be honest with you, but no, it fits in there, I think. okay, so you have to put it the other way. So it's a very specific way you have to put these things back in. Okay, the cube should be over here. Let's try if this fits. Yes, it fits. Okay, X button is on the bottom. I know that much. Let's see how this fits. Like this. This should be correct. Yes, fits perfectly. Okay, and the triangle is up here. Yes, and now it's in there. Oh, I just realized on the controller itself, there's only plastic, like cross circuit and everything, so you know where everything should be going. So I wish I had known that, and now let's put this thing on. You have to put it so the it's like horizontal, so these two little pegs in the middle are right in the rubber thing. Okay, and now this thing, I think there's no special way you have to put this in, so just put it in there. And now, let's see, triangle is this one. You have to put this in the right way, so the play and stop button are in the correct place. Okay, now for the hard part. You have to put the board back in. This shouldn't be too hard, just put this in here, but now, yeah, everything should be fine. And now you have to like put this cord in between here so it doesn't move around everywhere. And then just push these back into place. Now just put these back into the corners so the cord doesn't move around in the controller. And yeah, that was easier than I anticipated. Okay, now let's take the back of the controller. Whoops, sorry for the camera shake. And put this back on. And we are done. The controller is clean and put together once again. And now let's put these teeny tiny screws back in again. So I'll see you once I'm done with that. Okay, now the controller is completely put back together. All the buttons seem to work perfectly. But to be completely sure, let's put a game in and try it out. Okay, let's try out the controller we just cleaned. I put in Klonoa, one of my favorite PS1 games, and let's see if all the buttons work. I don't even know if Klonoa uses all of the buttons, but I'm sure it will be fine. No, I don't want to see a cutscene. Okay, now we have here the controller. Sorry for being out of focus. One thing has to be out of focus. Okay, let's move right, no problem. Left, no problem. Up, no problem. Down, no problem. Okay, if we jump, that's no problem at all. And this attack thingy, this one jumps as well, this attacks as well, and the shoulder buttons don't do anything. So let's just play the game how it's supposed to be played. And of course, miss this thing. No! Oh, okay. Well, whoop, whoop, gotcha. Bam. Okay, so everything seems to work fine. Okay, now I need an enemy. I need an enemy to get this thing. I don't have one. Well, no problem. So, but let's get these diamond things. Okay, so the controller works no problem at all. You can see I push the button and he jumps. Blop. Okay. Good. Controller works no problem. So you can see you can clean your controller that way. You can also do a bit of cosmetics as well. If you have like little scuffs and little marks on there, you can use a very fine sandpaper and put these away, but that takes off logos and everything, so be careful. And to be quite honest, I'm not doing that because this controller is for using, not for display, so there really is no need to do this. So yeah, thanks for watching. I hope I could help you clean your controller and kill Klonoa. So yeah, if you liked it, please leave a comment or something. Give it a thumbs up if you really like it that much. Subscribe to my channel to see more stuff all around retro video gaming and other things. And I hope I see you again in the future. And if you want to see anything cleaned, maybe I'll do another video. Just tell me in the comments. So yeah, see you then. Bye.